Hey guys, I'm gonna show you a little some actual housework. I've just been like too busy working really to even stop and make videos, just all day every day. There are a few garage updates on the Instagram. It's easy to find Last Humans Garage if you don't know about it. Made a two or three streaming videos today with working on the garage. It's not ready yet. Whew, it's a lot of work. All right, today we are going to, that bathroom is big. We are going to look at a toilet that doesn't work. Now, I'm starting fresh on this. I know as much as you. I'm going to pull the toilet off of the ground, out of the room, you know. So, because the tank drained good, but this doesn't drain good, I want to pull it out and really inspect the hole better with a little plunger thinger. I actually have a different one that's made better for this that I'm gonna go get, and just figure out why this one flushes slow but the others in the house are perfect. So the very first thing you do is, of course, you shut off all your water to the toilet and you flush as many times as you can to drain all the water. Now, it's very peculiar because when this is empty, this is supposed to drain down to the U-bend part, and it's not. But I've already put this through, and there's nothing clogged in here that I know of. Very strange. So, okay, I'll get to work. I'll open a clip again when there's something to show you here. All right, guys, I decided before I do pull this off the ground and have all that headache, that's just because I stirred some stuff up, I'm going to use my big drill-powered thing, and you'll always scratch up the bottom of your porcelain there. So I just found a perfect little bit of heater hose here, and that will be on the bottom of my bowl to protect it. And then I'll put this on. This might be 20, 25 foot. So I really expect there's something just under the floor, not in the toilet, but maybe it'll work and save me all that hassle of, I got a new seal, all the hassle of putting the toilet back on and everything. So let's try it out. Oh yeah, we're going power, all right. So let me get a starting point here. Okay, the rubber just goes right there to protect your bowl of happiness. Okay, start twisting this thing through. I'm gonna have to get it in a little more first. I'll tell you when it starts going, I'll come back. All right, well, I didn't have much luck with the snake going in properly. So the tank wouldn't, this toilet bowl wouldn't drain though. So all it takes here is a lot of fast plunging to force the water out instead of sitting here with a cup, you know? So now that it's just about empty, I do have the bolts out. One bolt on each, actually it's a nut. And then you have these little handles, these little finger spots where you gotta break it loose of this. Oh, this thing is, oops, I gotta do the water, I forgot. Let me undo the water pipe and then we'll get back to what I was just doing. All right, the water pipe is now disconnected. There we go. Yuck. I have a new gasket for that. The old wax ring. I'm sure there is a clog down here, and I'd be really stoked if we can find it together. So let's find out. The wax ring doesn't look that bad, so I hope somebody hasn't been in here recently to try and fix it with no luck. So we'll see how it goes. I've seen a lot worse condition wax rings before. This isn't that old, you know. I mean, sometimes it's super gnarly. This looks a little bit fresh, so could be bad news if someone tried to address this and they didn't have success. So I'll go ahead and keep cleaning this wax off and get back to you in a few minutes. The one good thing about this is you don't need any protective hosing now that we're going directly into the pipe. There's something that might be holding it up. Let's see, I'm gonna go like this and lock it in. Try and free all this up. And then you move the lever, try and get a little more. I may have freed something up. It's still going. It just takes a little effort. Maybe hung it up right about there. Bring it a little tighter. Lock it in place. Spin that crap around. Release. Try to go in a little more. Yeah. That's what she said, dude. Holy crap. I hope I can get this out. Okay, it's locked up a little more. If I fix this, I'm gonna trip out. All right. Spin. I wanted to just show you some cool spin. Let's try that. Can't see if this is the right way. No, it is not. Okay. Okay. That's pretty fun right there. All right, release. It's going again. I gotta be almost at the end of my rope here. There we go. 25 foot is in there. Uh-oh, I'm out of battery. All right. Now I'm going to try and pull this back up and hopefully it doesn't get stuck. Just like that. Kind of hard to do with one hand when I'm holding the camera. I need to hold the gun with one and then work my way back. All right, I'm gonna put this down. If I find anything super gross that comes out, I'll show you guys. This'll work. Like that. See? Hope it brings up a big old piece of hair. Now if it's still broke, I'm going to be bummed because, I mean, what the hell could it be if I did 25 foot through this pipe and it still doesn't drain? Because the other toilets drain. It isn't, it isn't the main pipe type of thing. So, this, I hope it did it, man. Dang. Nothing even on it. Lock that in place and we're done. Let's see. Let me get out the new seal stuff, and I'll show you that in a sec. All right, so we'll do this better than wax seal. I have used one of these somewhere else. And because it is flush here, I don't need to use the spacer to bring it up higher. So this is supposedly, and I mean, it's worked with the other one, the brand new technology that sort of never wears out. And that's all there is to it. And I'm gonna go ahead and put the toilet. I don't use the spacer, as I said. I don't even need the bolts because I got really good quality bolts here and good quality nuts. So I'm just gonna put the toilet back on and we'll do some tests. And if it doesn't work, then I probably gotta call the plumber. I mean, a 25-foot snake is about the max of my ability to fix this. All right, guys. So it didn't fix it, whatever I did, the snake. That was not the issue. The issue, I think, is the toilet itself. Of course, I did what you all do after I fail, and I went to Google. Now, toilets made between in about the early to mid 90s have the jets. You know, the jets squirt the water down when it flushes, and those can get clogged with mineral deposits and stuff. And that is when I noticed that I only have a dribble from the back one here. See those holes? Only like this one really works. They're all clogged. This is the actual toilet issue, I believe. So I'll just try something before I go buy a new toilet. I mean, they're not that expensive, 100, 150 bucks. But I got a coat hanger. I'm just gonna kind of ream those holes out and I'll be right back. All right, guys, so first off, this is a 1977 toilet. Can you read that? Probably not. It's 1977, right there. And it helped a little bit to kind of ream these out, although wasn't like I was breaking stuff loose. But you can see, before it wouldn't really even go down. Now it flushes a little bit once it gets going. But we decided, because it's a 77 model, what's that, 50 years old almost, we're going to go ahead and I'm going to buy my first toilet of my whole life. Anyway, so, I mean, even if I unclogged it a bit, it's still all corroded in the ring. Doesn't flow good, you know, whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna go to Depot, buy a toilet here. I'll see you guys in a bit. Going to Home Depot, guys. Pick up a throne. Jeez, I don't even know what to look for in throne shopping. All I know is I'm not gonna buy like a $69.99 Glacier Bay special. And I'm not gonna buy a $300 or $400 toilet either. I'm gonna look for just the middle range, $200 maybe, for a decent toilet. I'm really bummed. I haven't got to clean my car in so long. Haven't even had the car seats in it. Every day I just want to get that project done, but all the house stuff comes first. We're still really getting everything organized and everything. And then the first thing I'm going to do is detail my whole interior. There's tons of dirt in the back from everything I hauled. So I'll see you at Depot. And we have the Kohler Cimarron. Round ball, white bowl, white color, not biscuit color. And this thing weighs probably 100 pounds, so I'm gonna try and lift it. You realize I gotta go up about 20 stairs with this thing. Oh, in addition to my Hulkamania picture, you'll see soon, this one was my son's. I just put it in a frame for him today. I'm gonna get that in his room. That's pretty sweet too. Oh yeah, brother. All right, guys. Well, I just fell one step on the stairs, bringing this old one down. Luckily, it wasn't more steps and landed on my knee on the stone tile, but hey, I got it out. Bag to prevent drips. Old shitty toilet. No pun intended, I guess. Let's check out the new one. Now, it comes in two pieces. So I'm just working on the bottom right now. Ooh, it's beautiful. So the thing with that gasket, the special one I got, you want to tighten each side very carefully. You see it's sprung up and the gasket will compress and get it tight. So just go back and forth on your two screws as you tighten it up. And then make sure it's straight, and then we'll go ahead and try putting that tank on next. All right, so now we got the tank. Now there are only three things you do to the tank. First, you put your gasket, you put your seal on. And see, it comes all the way flush down like that. You hear it click. Now it is on. Then you gotta do your bolts. slide those bolts in right there. Now we're ready to lift it on, and should go right on pretty nice. Then you want to be careful with your nuts, of course. Don't over tighten them. You can see here, this is a new a piston plunger type thing that a lot of the newer toilets have now. This isn't like the jet flush that I've seen that has a huge, big, powerful tank, but this is some kind of new technology where you don't have to deal with the flapper valve anymore, none of those extra parts. So looking forward to seeing how killer this flush is pretty soon. It's just like the whole piston comes up. See that? Super cool. All right, guys. First try. Dry it. Looking good there. Okay, I'll open it up a bit more. All right. No leaks at the hose. Hold on a sec. All right, I do. Yep. Little bit of a leak there I gotta work on. All right, guys, back from depot a second time. Fresh hose with nice fresh gaskets. The other one just had old cracked gaskets. Figured that's probably the issue. So let's try this brand new hose right here. Looks like this time we're good. No drips coming out of the edges of this thing here. I can hardly talk anymore. My voice is so hoarse. Looking good there. So a new hose did solve it. The seals do wear out in those things. All right, it's almost full. Let's check out a flush in a minute. Check this out, the new piston type plunger. Oh, that is sick. That is quick. That's a quick, I wonder if I could probably hold the handle longer for a more water in or not. I don't know. Pretty cool. It works. All done, toilet fixed.